Walk around the compound, see some tigers, and then hopefully we'll see some Pete's.
Hello, you. Hello, you. Hi, beautiful. Hi, pretty girl. You excited? Yeah? You excited? She's like, of course I am. And I'm gonna be cute now. I'm excited, and I'm excited to be cute. I've been waiting all day to be cute, to flip on the cute switch. And you finally gave me the opportunity to do so. Thank you very much. Been waiting all day. Been waiting all day. Oh my gosh, look at you. Look at this pretty girl. Wow. Strong opener. Strong opener. Okay, sunset time in the compound. Sunset time. Beautiful day. Hello, all you big cat lovers out there. It's me, Derek, again. Welcome to another super duper fantastic walk around the compound webcast. Oh, this weather. My goodness. It's something else. It's about 80 degrees out right now. It's about 80 degrees. Now, some of you might be saying, oh my gosh, Derek, that is hot, hot, hot. I know some of you Canadians and some of you Scandinavians and all that stuff, you might be saying like, oh my gosh, too uncomfortable, don't like it, that's the hottest day of the year. But compared to what it has been, getting, you know, up to like 105, 110, I mean, just like last week before, I mean, you might as well be putting popsicles out on the ground. It's downright chilly. It's downright chilly. Yeah. Hi. This is Courtney's last day. Yeah, it is. Oh, sad. Oh my gosh, how you feel, Courtney? Having to leave all the kitties.
Oh, I don't like thinking about it.
Well, it's gonna happen in just a couple hours.
No.
No. I was so pathetic. Little. No. But yeah. Interns come and interns go, and you made it through. You made it. Yay! Yay! And you live in Texas, right? So you're gonna, yeah, it's not like, yeah, yeah, you're like right up the road, so it's not a big deal. Not a big deal. Hi, Sugar Lumps. She's like, why are they getting chicken? What? Why are they getting chicken? Because it's there in between. They're getting chicken. I don't know. I don't make the rules. She's like, that's Derek. That's not quite true. No, I don't. I don't. That's Heidi. That's Heidi and that's Rachel and them. Like, I don't spend enough time here. I don't spend enough time here to actually make any rules anymore. I barely know what's going on half the time. I mean, it's not too... I mean, I know. I don't want to make it seem like, I don't know what's going on ever. No, but... I'm considerably, oftentimes, yeah, and I'm out of the loop. And for obvious reasons, because I'm just not here. I spend more days of the week not here than here. So, yeah. Fun Ben. Ben. Bonnie. Bonnie Boo. Amin. Hi, baby. Hi. Hi, beautiful. Cutie pants. Yeah. Yeah. But it's such a rare like break in the temperature in the middle of August, and it's gonna last like all week. It's not just gonna be like one or two days, it's gonna be like a consistent pattern. It's gonna happen for a while. Oh, it's so wonderful. It's so nice. The cats are just up and out and enjoying themselves. I mean, it's really great. Really, really great. Oh my gosh, we got someone over here who is enjoying the sunset. Are you enjoying the sunset, Mr. Clyde? Yeah? Got some engines going by. Oh boy, some engines. Some engines. Yeah. Yeah, some cats get, they get a little bit of a supplement in between. They get a little bit of a supplement, so Courtney gets to go around, gets to be the chicken fairy. Yeah, he gets to be the chicken fairy, bestowing chicken magically upon the land. Cats like the chicken fairy. Sky meat, randomly falling sky meat. Oh. Yano, you don't even like chicken half the time. I always say half the time because sometimes you do. Oh. Yeah, sometimes you do eat chickens.
Oh.
Yeah. What do you think? He's like, I want some sky chicken. I don't think you need it.
I do.
Don't you tell me what I need and what I don't need, Derek. So, yeah. Oh. Everyone's up and about, having a good time, enjoying themselves. I know, the last few webcasts, there's been a lot of cats that just haven't been up and at them. Have not been up and at them. Just because of the temperature. It's just so, it's uncomfortable. You just can't get anything done in this type of weather. Capture. What? We want. Well, you gotta be butting yourself into things, Peaser. Poobluga. Poobluga. Hi, bud. Hey. Oh. We are running into an interesting issue that, I mean, we've had to do it in the past, but it seems like we're doing it with a lot more frequency these days. Turning away meat. Turning away meat. With a little, and not some, you know, you gotta be asterisk, so be careful how you like read into that, but. Yeah, we'll have livestock donations, and people say, like, I've got something dead. And then we're just like, well, our freezer's full. Sorry, we can't take it. And they're like, well, shucks. And, I mean, because this is, I mean, the big thing is that, you know, the number of cats that we have, it's not not what it used to. And when when I first came around, Sass, are you going to sit there all day? All the live long day. Sass. Sass. Cassie. Sass. Sass. Sass, sass, sass. Really? Really? That is a bunch of bull sugar. Well. I'm just gonna... If Cassie's gonna boycott me, I'm just gonna boycott her. Boycott, girlcott, gender fluid cot. All sorts of cots. We're gonna be laying cots down. Sleeping on cots. How many cot jokes can you make? So many cot jokes.
That sounds like if like there was like a foreigner. Like, just, like, came to the compound for the first time. Look at all the cots!
I am surrounded by cots! So many cots! Oh, gosh. These cot jokes. They gotta stop. They gotta stop. Oh, so, yeah. It's some intern's last day. It's some intern's first day. They're over there. Rachel's showing them some ropes and whatnot. I mean, literally, she's just like picking up a bunch of ropes. She's like, here's a piece of rope. And then she like picks up another rope. And then she's like, here's another piece of rope. And they're like, why is she just showing us ropes? I thought we were here to work with cats. And she's like, don't question my teaching methods. Okay. New girls, we'll meet them later. Just know that they're here. But, yeah, Becky and Courtney and Andrew, all three in one day, shoop, gone. New ones, coming in. And the cycle continues. Training a new generation of young people. It's strange because we'll get these interns, you know, now that they're aware of the content. And there's some, like the one today, she's like, I just, it's kind of embarrassing to say that I've been watching you for a couple of years. And I was just like, just kind of being playful. But I'm just like, yeah, that's cool. All right. We'll go over some more spiels and stuff like that. But, I had to reiterate the point. I had to tell him, like, look, I put my big dumb face out there. Hi. Often. Hi. I put my big dumb face out there very prominently for all to see. So people then, you know, naturally will make the assumption that, like, oh, well, he's Care. That's Mr. Care. And those are his cats. And it's just like, because, like, when you get these workers here, it's just like, okay, I'm not here. Like I said before, I'm here. I'm not here more days than I am here. So it's like, you have to tell them right away. I'm just like, okay, I'm sure that you're really excited to see, you know, because I've been inside your phone. For a couple years now, but I realized that for the duration of your internship, like, your primary supervisor is going to be Rachel, and then, of course, then this is true always, and it's been true since I started, you know, like, Heidi is the one above all of us. You gotta listen to me. Sometimes interns, they lose sight of that. And then it's hard to shake it. Sometimes volunteers, sometimes people, they come out, Derek! And then, you know, and then just Heidi's just like, oh, and that's that lady. And she's like, she's the reason that all this is here. I mean, it's, yeah, it can be really frustrating. It can be really frustrating for me and certainly for her. Oh, yeah. Yeah. There's definitely been a number of them. We've had, conversations about that. A lot. I mean, imagine. Hi, Rachel.
Hi.
Everyone really liked your webcast.
Oh, yay.
Yeah, they did. Oh, my gosh.
Indeed.
And also, like, the fact that, like, someone said that you snuffle better than I do.
I do.
No.
Could have a snuffle
on
legend.
I don't think so.
My favorite comment.
I've snuffled more times than you ever will.
I don't think so.
I think so because I basically just practice snuffles in my car.
No.
Like,
I
snuffle for at least like 2 to 3 hours a day.
Lies.
No, not lies. That's how it is. Oh, we got some new people. It's those ones over there. Who are you? Where are you from?
Chantal, from Oklahoma City.
Oklahoma, where are you from?
From Denver.
Ah, cool. Say hi to everyone.
Hi.
There we go. We'll be seeing more of them as the months go on. How long are you here for? 4 months?
4 months.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. First day, and they're already covered in blood. Did you fall down? Did you slip?
Nope.
Okay. That's good. Hey, bud. How you doing? What do you know? Good. Good chat. They're, they seem good. Yeah, you know, first day. And we had a bunch of cows. I had to go shoot a bunch of cows in the head and go pick them up. You gotta be careful because when I say, like, yeah, I gotta go pick them up, it's because we've been picking up from these people for, you know, for a very long time. It's one of the local livestock sale yards. They've kept us, like, from literal starvation, like a number of times. They've fed us for years, so we kind of have, like, yeah, we will go and pick up their stuff. Don't, like, you can't, like, oh, they just go and pick up. Like, no. We used to. A lot. That was my thing. And I think I've talked about that in the webcast where, like, I would, my big deal was I'd come on the weekends. Heidi would have all of the cow and horse pickups from all over Wise County. She would just give me a list. And she would say, go forth. Go forth, my young Padawan. Go and kill things across the land and bring back the spoils of your conquest. And I would like, there would be like a list of like four or five like different cows and horses just all over the place, all over Wise County. And I'd be out for hours and hours and hours. And I would come back and I'd butcher and I'd load up the freezer. And that was like a big part of like my job, like early in back in the day. But, you know, as word spreads and as more people understand, and then also as we lose more, it's like a thing where it's like the knowledge spreads of like how we feed, and then also the number of our cats will kind of diminish. And then those two elements put together make it so we can sustain ourselves on people who drop off and very limited pickups. So yeah. Oh, they pick up. No. Someone get calls and be like, can you come get my horse? I'm like, no, we can't. Why not? You went and got the other. No, it's not how it works. Well, you gotta think, if you have something that's dead that weighs, you know, like 1500 pounds and it's just like sitting in your yard, and then you're just like, what am I gonna do with this thing? And then you're maybe like, you are the glimmer of hope, you know, and then you have to say like, I can't help you. They sometimes won't get too pleased when you have to tell them that news. No, I'm sorry, we can't go get it. And like, what? What incarnation is this? Oh, yeah. Everyone's just having a good time. Whew. I slept for a really long time. The morning of yesterday that I woke up, I had off and on, I slept for about 16 hours. I'm working night shifts, so I work night shifts and out of state, and then I drive a good number of hours here when my night shift is done, and then depending, there may be a couple things that I have to do like in and around the facility, which I'll do, and then I crash, and then I ended up crashing for about 16 hours. That was marvelous. I haven't been getting too much sleep besides that. I love sleep. Oh, it's the best. Such a good thing. Such an amazing thing. You're doing a good job, Rachel.
Thanks.
Not as good as I would, though.
Yeah, you want to show me? You want to do the rest of the buckets, or?
No, see, how will you learn? We learn by doing, not by watching. What is this, like some sort of like classroom? You taking notes or something? I know.
We need to walk before they can run.
Yeah, exactly. So, you gotta money where mouths go. I think that's how that goes. Yeah. Oh, look at these ugly tigers. They're gross. Yes, they do. They're like, Papa Derek, whoa, we haven't seen you. Yes, they do. Papa. It's like some little Eastern European boy. What stories do you have from the war, Papa? Hi, bud. Hi, blow, 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 blow. Oh, blow, 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 blow. Oh, blow, 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 blow. Whoa! Bow! Boosh! Got you! Zoobs, you got him! And now you will sit on him and smoosh him. Yes. As a symbol of your domination. This is, at this point, it's not really dominating anymore. It's just kind of, mushy and squishy. It's adorable. Not really dominating. Oh my gosh. Look at those boys. Look at those boys. You too. There's something else. See, everyone's in such a good mood. I mean, when you have to hunker down for weeks and just conserve your energy, being able to kind of get out in the sun and in the grass, it just feels good. It just feels good for them. All right, boys, wiener's up. Same the formation. That's, you know, the symmetry. It's impressive. It's impressive. Oh my gosh, they're even like moving in conjunction with each other. This is ridiculous. You know, I didn't want this to be like an overly extended webcast. I did want to kind of like keep this one like relatively tight, but you guys make it real hard. Make it real hard. Some other updates. Pride Strong week long data is going to be happening relatively soon. I cannot put an exact time frame on it, but one thing I will say about it is I am just really, really happy, very, very excited to be able to show everyone all of the data that was collected. We got some really, really awesome people, Joff and Melanie. They're amazing. They're just super smart. Way, way smarter than me. I mean, just insane. Like, there's no way I could have done this without them. They're bringing some skills to the table that are not, they're not just like, I'm good with numbers. Like, no, I'm like, have advanced education in data analysis type stuff. I'm so excited to be able to show you guys all of the Pride Strong week long stuff. And we've got some really great data, really great things that are going to be coming through, some really awesome stories. So some of you may be wondering, like, well, you know, are we going to ever see that stuff? Yes, soon. There's going to be some other things that hopefully you guys will be seeing soon. Oh, you know, carerescuetexas.com, carerescuetexas on Instagram. Heidi is on Instagram, Heidi Berry Cron. Berry is her maiden name. Didn't know if you guys knew that. Yeah, it is. It is. We are booking rooms in the Safari Suites. Just so you folks know, booking rooms in the Safari Suites. Yeah. that's a new section on the website that, oh my gosh, that new section on the website is so awesome. Heidi and Rachel put that together. So on top of all the stuff that Heidi and Rachel already do here at the Center for Animal Research and Education, they took on another hat of web developers. So even if you don't plan on booking any rooms in the Safari Suites, just go visit that site. It's just, the section is really great. They did an awesome job. Awesome job. Locked. So yeah, room there. You got the room to see the BBs, and then you got the view over here of the Cheekies. Ah! Did it! Texas! Texas! It's great! Sunset. Symmetry. Look at this symmetry.
Look at this BB symmetry. Oh my gosh. I mean, you can't get much cuter than that.
Yeah, you can.
You can't get any cuter. That's world record cuteness right there. World record. Just, you can't be beat. Can't be topped. Oh my gosh, Becky. It's also Becky's last day. Say goodbye to everyone, Becky. Your quietness and your awkwardness will be sorely missed. Okay, we'll watch them do chicken. They says no? They says no chicken? Do they? Can you throw it over? Oh, okay, never mind. Never mind. No, 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 no. They're not going to eat it? Oh. Well, hard choices at this point. Oh, listen to the boss or get it over the fence. Oh my gosh. How come they get chicken? How come they get chicken? Oh, missed the throw. They have a lukewarm response. Yeah, no, and I've talked about this in the webcast before, but yeah, sometimes like that. I'm gonna go back to a previous topic, but yeah, sometimes the big cat Derek stuff is, it can be a frustrating thing as far as the dynamic of the relationship I have, you know, with the person who founded this facility and has been here for the last 26, 27 years, something like that. And it's one of those things where it's like, look, I'm, you know, so happy and so wonderful and so excited for all the visibility that you've brought, honey, and this is your thing and I'm proud of you and it's so amazing, but it is, look, it bugs you when you'll get just, you know, all of these, when you get all of these, like, messages, like, just nonstop, just like, Derek, 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 Derek. And, you know, when you're the one that actually built the place. And it's not sitting there trying to say just like, where's my, it's just like, look, it's just, it gets to be a bit much. So. I always say, please, and so many of you are really great at this. So many of you are really, really awesome at this. You follow Heidi on her Instagram account, but just make sure that you throw some love. Please. Don't do it just because I'm saying, like, it's like this, like, or it's a pity thing or something like that, but just recognize and respect, like, you know, the actual hero here. It's not me. I am just the goofy guy. I'm just a goofy guy that is good at getting people's attention. That's it. That's all I'm good at. Oh, you're selling yourself short, Derek. You're good at a lot of things. Oh, no, I'm aware of all, you know, like a lot of my talents, and I have a realistic. I used to think that I was like really awesome at so many. I'm so smart because in what. Young man is not completely, you know, full of himself. They are. Like, young men between the ages of, like, 16, 17 up until about, like, 21, 22 are, I think, quantifiably, like, the dumbest creatures on earth. And I was no different. And I thought I was so awesome for a lot of different reasons. And then you get, you know, then life happens and then life hits you. And then it's like, I'm not awesome? What? And then it messes with you. And then, you know, so then you have to kind of pick yourself back up and then you have to figure out like, okay, well, let's see if we can try to reevaluate this. Let's see if we can reapproach this whole life thing And then you actually start to take a realistic look at yourself, like, okay, well, this is actually what I'm good at, and like, let's see if we can just kind of do away with all that other stuff, all that other fluff. Let's cut the fluff and trim the fat and all that fun stuff. So, you know, that's what I did, and it's a continuous process. Every day, trying to just, you know, understand your limits, understand your own, like, humanity, understand your own sense of self, your own, like, what you can honestly bring to the table, but then at the same time, like, still trying to push the limit of what it is that you can do. And still having, you know, hopes, and still having dreams, and still having ambition. Yeah. Life stuff. Oh man, now we're getting all lemur-sophical. Alright. Well, I think it's probably a good place to end it. Hey, it was a good cast. Good energy. Good vibe. Good job, everyone. Good job.
High five.
Nice. Like it. Loving it. Everyone did really, really good. Teamwork makes the webcast happen. All right, folks. I'll talk to you later, okay? All right. Bye-bye.